crude knot nematodes are something that no gardener really wants. They're microscopic worms, but the damage that they do to roots of plants is really visible. Plants will wilt easily. They might look chlorotic or yellowed. Now, soil tests can confirm the severity of nematodes and the type of nematodes that you have in your soil. There are many different kinds. But if you've been having trouble growing tomatoes, okras, or pumpkins, that might be the source of your problems. Now, peppers, eggplant, cucumbers, even roses can be affected by nematodes, and they will weaken woody plants like fruit trees and make them more susceptible to other problems. They're not really active in the soil when the temperature is below 64 degrees, so we can do a lot of the cool season crops easily without too much nematode issues. Now, if you introduce soil into your landscape that has nematodes, or if you purchase or get infected plants from someone else who has nematodes, or use contaminated tools. If someone works in someone's garden that has nematodes and doesn't clean their tools, that can introduce nematodes into your garden. So don't share root divisions or bulbs if you have nematodes in your soil. You can do cuttings, though. They can't be completely eradicated, but they can be controlled. Now, increase the organic material in your soil as much as possible to increase the beneficial soil microbes that you have to help fight off nematodes. Drip irrigation and mulch will help to avoid plant stress. And plant nematode-resistant varieties whenever possible. Look for the N on tomatoes. Varieties like Celebrity, Lemon Boy, Viva Italia, and Better Boy are great varieties for nematode resistance. There's more information about nematodes, and I've listed some more varieties of plants that are nematode-resistant on our Central Texas Gardener website. You want to plant as early as possible to get a head start before the soil warms up and the nematodes become very active. You can add cornmeal to the soil. That also helps to boost soil life and can be very effective for controlling them. You can add Actinovate. This is something that I've been using for a couple of years now, and it's really amazing. It's the only way I've been able to grow okra at Lake Austin Spa, where our soil is very sandy, alluvial soil. And it's an expensive product, but you only need to use 6 ounces per acre for control. Now, chitin products that are crab shells and shrimp cells, like Clandosan, can also be added to the soil to help with nematodes. You'll put that in several weeks before harvest, before you're planting. Sesame oil and extracts from Chilean soap bark trees are also used for combating nematodes. You can plant Elbon rye as a cover crop and then till it in, and that can help put nematodes definitely back. Planting marigolds, brassicas, mustards, even castor beans can help. Solarizing your soil or allowing it to be fallow can help with controlling the population of nematodes in your soil. So there's something that you can work around and still have a great garden and harvest, but you'll have to really concentrate on good health in your soil and good garden practices. For Backyard Basics, I'm Trisha Shirey. Thanks for watching.